I see. You're familiar with the unfortunate occurrence, the accident with Brutus the Barber Beefcake, are you not?
Well, you know, when I first heard about that, I thought he had gone and quit the World Wrestling Federation to play hockey.
To play hockey?
Somebody told me he had a face-off. I'm sorry.
You sure are. Ladies and gentlemen, Brutus the Barber Beefcake! Brutus, welcome to primetime. Welcome back to the WWF.
Great to be here. Great to be here.
Let's talk a little bit about your accident, the boating accident. Tell us a little bit about it, if you would.
Well, on a serious note, Vince, you know, it was more a little more than an accident, but, you know, what happened to me, most people would never survive this type of an accident. Mm-hmm. You know, the doctor said, well, we're going to work, we're going to try. Maybe we can save your eyes. Maybe you won't be paralyzed. Maybe we can even just save your life. That's what we're going to be happy with. Mm-hmm. Well, as you can see, I devoted 110% of my time to working out, to getting in the gym, to taking care of business. And thanks to the big man upstairs, I came through this thing in one piece. And now I'm bigger and badder than I ever been.
All right, we have some shots. Let's take you to some photos here, and tell us a little something about this, if you would. This is the frontal skull, right? Now, there are screws. What is all of that?
That's a little bit of space-age technology right there, yeah. Vince. There's a lot of steel, some titanium screws, a lot of wire, and little stuff.
How many screws, exactly?
Approximately 30 screws or so, something like that.
Mm. All right, we have another shot here, I think. This is from a side view, I believe. Of the same, a similar situation where they had to put a lot of wire and screws and everything in there on the side.
That's
as well.
That's correct. Basically, this was kind of an experimental
look at that
operation. You know,
brace. You can see that metal brace on the side
that's
there.
Right. That's correct. To tie everything, they took a lot of bone from my skull and placed that all across my whole face. Was completely destroyed in the accident. Mm-hmm. Basically, all the bone was vaporized. Doctors were
just shattered.
So dumbfounded that they couldn't believe what had actually happened. They weren't exactly sure how to deal with it, so they basically had to try this kind of an experimental operation there. It took basically about 12 hours from start to finish.
Putting you back together.
Put me back together, but now, you know, I'm back. I'm mad.
That's amazing. Just amazing. What's amazing?
Amazing they can reconstruct a man's face with screws and bolts and everything, and guy's 6'3" or 4", 270 pounds, got close to 8-9 inches of material on him. Worst case of mops I've ever seen.
Terrific.
Is that even munching on his clothes again?
Brutus has opened his own barber shop here in the WWF.
That should be neat.
And we're going to show you a little footage now from the very first time Brutus opened his barber shop. The Earthquake was his guest, his first customer.
What's he doing now?
Uh-oh,
he's gonna cut his hair.
Rudolph got something.
He's got a snake.
A rubber snake.
Yeah. Yeah.
Snake!
Yeah.
Snake!
Yeah. All right!
All right!
Rudolph's having a little fun there with the Earthquake, and he's gonna have a little bit more fun when we return because he's gonna do a little hairstyling with somebody, maybe.
Go look at me!
All right, back. A little more action here with Brutus, the barber beefcake, and, well, you ready to do a little cutting and strutting?
Well, you know, summertime's almost here, Vince, and you know I like to see those haircuts high and tight. So I'm gonna do a special one here, but you know, something missing here. I need a little music to get me in the mood, you know, so I can really get in there and do the right kind of job that I need to do.
I see.
Why don't you go ahead and hit it, boys?
What?
Oh, where can that old tiger be?
Knock yourself out, Brutus.
All right.
Chris Wardell for Haid, four youngest brothers.
Where in the world can that thin little tiger be?
Maybe a little
hay. How in that hay?
Look at the guy in the chair, McMahon.
Look
at him real close, the guy in the chair.
You look at him close.
It's like Ted Bundy right before they put the juice to him.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God. Maybe we'll just skip the shave, you know?
Have your fun, you son of a gun.
Ted Bundy before they put the juice?
Yeah.
Ask him what he wanted in the morning. Breakfast, and I'll just have some juice.
Where's that tiger?
But after that, he quit smoking.
I really like it.
Hold that tiger.
Let me enjoy this, will you, please? This is styling in the truest sense of the word.
What's the matter with this guy? What are you doing over here?
What do you mean?
Not a good-looking guy to begin with anyway. Look at this.
All right, Brutus, get it, Brutus, get it.
Where's that tiger? Where's that tiger?
You know what?
Where can you be?
What would you call that style? So far, beefcake to the side?
Yeah.
They all cry now. Please play that
like
tiger rag for me.
No, thank you.
Why not?
Tiger,
I don't have much hair.
Couldn't be a stylist, couldn't it?
Brutus was taught by the best, by the way.
Hello.
Sal Fodera, world champion, broke Brutus in.
Hello, my baby.
Sal Fodera, broke him in.
Sal Fodera, is that right, Dom, from San Bernardino?
No.
All right, now this is art.
They need a company.
If you refuse to be humble, then you'll be left alone, oh baby. Telephone and tell me I'm your very own. Yum, yum,
got a baby, but she's not a
joint. Like
you know, after a haircut like that, you can also get a shave, nails done, and neutered.
Neutered?
I believe so. What difference is it going to make? Looking like that, he's not going to do any good anyway.
Now, wait a minute. This is a special cut. Yeah, this is a very special cut.
Then I ring
the must be from the Stevie Wonder School of Haircutting.
And this is what I say.
Look at that.
He is destroying a human being, or subhuman.
Hey, come on. You may be next in the chair,
oh,
by the way.
Right.
He's looking for another customer.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime son.
Get the armpits.
Send me a kiss by wire. Baby, my heart's on fire, on fire.
By the way, how about that rock and roll, huh?
If you refuse me, honey.
There's nothing... better than acid barbershop.
Acid barbershop?
Yeah. Heavy barbershop metal.
Metallica doesn't have a thing to worry about, huh?
Is that AC/DC singing?
Get the hook! Somebody gong them! They're done! From out back.
Oh boy, this is
always been one of my favorites.
I heard you humming that the other day.
Look at that haircut.
It's like the north end of an audience.
All right, let's get a real good look at Brutus's work.
Come on, Bobby. Come on over here. Come on, get up here. Come on.
I can get up there. I'm going to take a look.
Come back here.
On a Sunday morn, settlement forlorn.
Very nice, yeah. Brutus. That is very, very, very nice.
Yeah. Funny thing is, that does look like how he should look.
We must stay home, Joe.
All right, why don't you stand up and let's get a good look at this piece of art. Slowly turn.
If you sing your troubles away,
somebody paying them?
Keep your sunny side up.
Good, keep your sunny side up. Knock mine over easy. Brutus, how can we thank you?
Well, you know, I've had a great time, and I'll tell you what, I'll be back in a little while and lead all the people with a sing along.
But everybody's going to sing along. We'll be back with more prime time. Stay with us, everybody. Hey, take it easy, huh? What kind of nod is that?
Look at this.
Look at what?
Look at this.
You like your haircut?
Beautiful. I love it.
It's a nice haircut if you're going to the chair.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake is coming back. And he just cut a little bit more hair.
Just a moment, but right now, standing by to tell you how you can be a part of this extraordinary bunch. Alfred, take it away.
Thank you, Vince. For those of you who would like to be a part of the fun here in the studio when we're televising primetime wrestling, you'll have to write to an address to get some tickets. And here's the address you write to. Primetime Tickets.
If people want to have fun, be part of primetime, send me a sweatshirt. Put a picture of your girlfriend on it, the school you went to, a massage parlor.
Hey, come
whatever
on.
You want. Send it to me extra large. You're going to be fun. Part of part time.
Yeah,
time
or
too.
Something yeah. like that. Now it's time to sing along.
All right.
All yours. Some you ate?
Me.
Good night, ladies.
I taught you. Now let's do the one I taught you.
Oh. The Alzheimer's kicked in.
Let me call you Weasel.
Join us next week for more World Wrestling Federation Prime Time. Go get him, Brutus. Go get him.
All right. Woo. Let me introduce you first, my guest this week. Accompanied by General Adnan, Commanding Officer, Colonel Mustafa,
Mass Confusion,
Sergeant Slaughter.
Things may get hot here, if you know what I mean.
Turncoat.
Coat.
occupation of the World Wrestling Federation title was cut short by a certain patriot, Hulk Hogan missile in WrestleMania. Shut your mouth, you Hulk Hogan sympathizer. Everybody knows that you and that immortal slime, Hulk Hogan, go way, way back. You're just like this. That's you, and that's him. You know that? Hulk Hogan, I told you at WrestleMania 7 to be prepared to dig that foxhole a little bit deeper. Because I, Sargent Slaughter, rule the World Wrestling Federation. And that means that I will stop at nothing to destroy you, Hulk Hogan and Hulkamania. If that means taking a chair and beating you over the head with it, I'll do it. If it means taking a bazooka and using it, I'll do it. If it means taking a ball of fire and throwing it in your face, I'll do it. You know, you and Hulk Hogan have a lot more in common these days. Your faces, your disfigurement, yours by an accident, and his by design. WrestleMania 7, but the war has just begun, Hulk Hogan. Being a drill instructor, I know about conditioning, and you're in no condition to face Sergeant Slaughter, and I can't wait to tear that bandage off your face and show the scar, the disfigurement on your face that not only is on your face, but goes into your heart and all the hearts of those puka maniacs. I rule the World Wrestling Federation, and there's nothing you or those puka maniacs can do about it. And that's an order.
Well, he used to rule the World Wrestling Federation. He doesn't rule it anymore. The Hulkster does.
Say the Hulk would be toast of the World Wrestling Federation.
Now, my very special guest toast, he's the master of the strut and cut. He's none other than Brutus, the barber cheesecake.
All right.
Brutus, I have to say, you definitely have that spring back in your step. Welcome to Spotlight, and above all, welcome back to the World Wrestling Federation.
Thank you, Ian. It's great to be back in the World Wrestling Federation. You know, a lot of people have been wondering, what happened to the barber? Well, just let me tell you this, brother. I was down and out. The barber couldn't have gone down any farther. I was in trouble, brother. I was busted up bad. I got a lot of steel plates, a lot of screws, a lot of wire, and a lot of things going through my head, brother. But that's okay, because the big man upstairs and me made a deal. And I'm back. And I'm back with a vengeance, man. And I got a surprise for you. You know, I opened up a barbershop right here in the World Wrestling Federation, and I just can't wait because I'm excited. We're going to get to have a lot of fun. I'm going to do a lot of cutting and a lot of other things, too.
Well, we've already seen the barbershop. As a matter of fact, coming up this week here on Spotlight, we're going to take a look at a recent appointment you had with the Nasty Boys.
Oh, yeah.
I can't wait to see that.
Hey, you know, Ian, I've been watching you, brother, and I think I can help you out, man. I can give you just that extra look that you need,
well,
brother.
You think I need a trim?
Yeah, I got a light schedule today, so I can work you in.
I don't know
no
if Sergio over at Quasi de Roma's there.
Oh, yeah.
Happy about.
Oh, yeah.
Right now, let's
get good wheel.
Brutus, getting things going here this week in the barbershop.
Wait a nasty boy. Wait till you see that.
Those choppers are really sharp, too.
Yeah.
Brutus, I got a lot of fans here, Reno.
Yeah, both of them.
couple of guys in the World Wrestling Federation who could use a trip to the barber shop. It's my next guest. Let me introduce to you first the manager, Jimmy the Mouth of the South Park, and the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion, the Nasty Boy.
I don't know how you could improve on their haircut. Looks like they already got chopped a little bit on the side.
The way they like it. No, I can tell them. I'd like to tell them. I'd love it.
You can take a little off the back, Brutai.
You two sure could use a little help. I'm glad that you made it to the barber shop. We don't need you. We don't need them. We don't need anybody. We got the World Wrestling Federation tag team titles around our waist, and that's all we need. Hey, we're the biggest. We're the baddest. We're the meanest. We're the toughest. We're the nastiest two people in the World Wrestling Federation. We'll take anybody on and beat everybody up because we're as nasty as we want to be.
We better see their orthodontist, too. Yeah. High five with that little run.
Well, you know, it's quite obvious to me as I look at you two gentlemen to see just why it is they call you two the Nasty Boys. Hey, I'm all out of time. You know, it's just about time for my next appointment, and I don't think that you two gentlemen want to be here when they arrive.
Uh-oh. You know what that means, Monsoon. Legion of Doom about to invade the barbershop.
Looks like it's all over for the barbershop. These two guys aren't the most friendliest people in the world either, believe me.
Sparks will be flying here in a moment.
Now, if you were driving by and looked in the window and needed a haircut, would you stop in there?
We just came in for a little trim.
But you already got a trim.
Of them two heads, it looks like this dude cut your hair. Hey! I'm coming out here, and I'm speaking on behalf of all these people in the WWF and my partner, Hawk. Hey! Severia and psoriasis. The last thing you puppies need to do is get our stinking dandruff up.
Things heating up here in the barbershop. These guys could be into it in seconds here.
The knobs looks a little worried.
Confidence all over the faces of Legion of Doom.
It's going to bust loose here, Monsoon. I can feel it. Here they go. Here they go. Look at his hand. Look at his hand.
Look at Brutai. He's smiling.
You're lucky we got an appointment at a first-class joint for a pedicure.
They're lucky to have the belt.
Good move, Jimmy. He got him out of there.
Yeah, that little runt.
Well, gentlemen, I'm glad you stopped by because we're going to have to do something about this stuff.
All right, Legion of Doom.
Brutus, after taking a look at that barbershop, I guess you really don't need an appointment to get in to see you. Now, let me get this straight. Now, your client list includes the Legion of Doom. You cut their hair?
Oh, don't worry, brother. I'm going to take care of you just the way I take care of the Legion of Doom.
And Mean Gene Okerlund's hair?
Of course Mean Gene's hair.
And the big boss man.
And the big boss man, too.
You sure?
Oh, yeah.
I don't think I really need any more taking off.
This is really going to be good.
Right, now, let's get back to the ring and some action involving the Intercontinental Champion, Mr. Perfect. Well, once again, Brutus, we saw some great action right here on Spotlight, and it was great to find out that the Ultimate Warrior's condition is improving after his appearance on the funeral parlor with Paul Bearer.
Well, you know something? This Ultimate Warrior, man, he's an intense dude.
and I'm sure that he's not going to take this thing lying down, if you know what I mean.
What do you think about the Undertaker? Oh, it seems like anybody can stop him.
You know something? The Undertaker is a big, mean dude. You know, I've never seen anybody quite like this Undertaker before. He can take pain. He can take a beating. And he doesn't even show any emotion. No emotion whatsoever. He's like a dead man almost.
Well, so that's why he's called the Undertaker. Next week, we are going to see another edition of the Funeral Parlor. Paul Bearer's guest will be none other than Sargent Slaughter.
Who? Sargent Slaughter. You know something? This guy's playing by a whole new set of rules. He's thrown the rule book completely out. But you know something? There's a man, and his name is Hulk Hogan, and he's not going to put up for this kind of stuff at all. Sergeant Slaughter, you're going to have to deal with him, and he's not going to have his rule book with him either.
Well, that's all coming up next week right here on Spotlight, and I hope you didn't throw out the mirror. Can I take a look at...
One more second. Just one more little thing. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Here you come. A little bit of beefcake there.
What is this? Brutus, I don't think this is
brother,
me.
My next appointment's going to be here shortly. So I got to run, brother. You take it. Be cool, pal.
Well, thanks a lot, Brutus. Can somebody get Sergio on the phone? It's Quasi De Roma. We'll see you next week right here on WWF Wrestling Spotlight.
You know, my next appointment has just arrived, and I couldn't be prouder than to be the one to introduce to you now the immortal Hulk.
Shown his true colors when he chose to open a new phase, brother. You won the battle, brother, but the war rages on. Sergeant Slaughter has definitely declared war and shown that no lines are drawn, no rules are gonna prevail.
You know something? That's right, Brutus. When he threw the fire in my face after WrestleMania 7 in the locker room, it made all the Hulkamaniacs realize what he meant by no rules. And then when he casually strutted out here on the barbershop and made reference to your mug, brother, the way it was squashed by Mother Nature, maybe it's just a freak accident, but my casualty, my burn on the side of my face was by design, Sergeant Slaughter. That made me and all my Hulkamaniacs realize, whether it was napalm, let it be napalm. Whether it's gasoline, let it be gasoline. Or whether it's Army, Navy, the Marines, tanks, guns, or bazooka, or out and out, hand-to-hand combat, Slaughter. Let's get it on, brother, because we're ready for you, and we're not afraid of anything that Sergeant Slaughter has in store for us. These are his rules, Brutus.
Well, you know something, Hulkster? I know that Sergeant Slaughter is definitely waiting for an opportunity to take you down so that maybe he can take and spray some Agent Orange or something all over those Hulkamaniacs, brother. What are you going to do when the horror sets in across the faces of all the Hulkamaniacs?
Well, you know, Barber, when you get ready for war, brother, you got to be ready to win. You got to put everything into it you got, man. Body, mind, soul, and everything. And you got to have something that you're fighting for. But there are casualties, man. There are horrors of war, brother. But it always reads in the children's faces, man. And if it was anybody else other than my little Hulkamaniacs, the horrors of war would be the end of Hulkamania. But if something would happen that the Hulkster would get hurt in this all out and out war, the horrors of war would turn around and bite Sergeant Slaughter in the butt, brother, because those little Hulksters would fight for me. They stand in line, millions at a time, armed, ready and pumped to whip Sergeant Slaughter. So when I get you in the ring, brother, it's not just gonna be shave and a haircut, two bits. It's going to be Hulkamania's going to run wild until you call it quits. What you going to do?
Good, Admiral.
Oh, he looks fantastic. It's like he's gaining a little weight in the upper body. The size of the arms of that guy.
Oh, Cedar Rapids, welcome to the barber shop. You know, tonight, my first appointment is a man who's been with the World Wrestling Federation for many, many years. He's like a legend in his own time. But recently, the $1 Million Man and Scary Sherry have taken it upon themselves to try to end this individual's career all by themselves. But you know, and I know, that the rowdy one will never, ever stoop down to the level of the $1 Million.
Kisser, Admiral.
Oh, yeah. Unless you get him mad. Then you got a guy in a leather jacket and a skirt mad at you.
Wow. Not
the leather jacket.
Doesn't have the crutch anymore either.
Hang on a second. I wanna say something here. First of all, I want you to have a seat, Mr. Brodie, because I got a little something I want to tell you about men. I want to tell you about what you are. You just get and get yourself comfy. I know it's your barbershop. A little trim around the ears, you're looking great. You know, this man right here, Mr. DiBiase, a little lesson for you here. This man right here, 8 months ago, was in the ocean, treading water, playing with the sharks. I don't know what you're doing. Turn around, and somebody hits him in the face and tears his face off. This guy right here now. Now, for 3 days, he's in the hospital. He's not waking up. He's basically sipping tea with the angels is what he's doing. Everybody knows he wakes up 3 days later. This is a man now. He wakes up 3 days later. He's got, 30 screws in the head, 8 plates in the face, face all puffed up. People saying to him, people saying, you ain't never gonna do it again. And that's the will. You know, we got a friend of all of ours, Michael Landon, just found out he got cancer. And I was reading, and he come public. I'm sitting here worried about my little knee, man. I'm in company. Michael Landon got cancer, and he says, I ain't gonna quit. It's all in the attitude. I can't pull it through. I'm sitting here with him, a man that did pull it through. Not only that, 8 months later, you come out, you be in shape, and you got your own barbershop. That is pure man. And I'll tell you something, DiBiase, the thing you can't buy is heart. The thing you can't buy is that human instinct. And if Michael Landon ain't quitting, if he didn't quit, I'll be damned if I'm gonna quit. And you know something?
Mr. Perfect, I've seen enough of this as your life. Get out!
Brutus, don't they, Animal?
They sure do. It looks like he got carried away with the scissors on his own outfit.
Here, let me introduce him to you. He calls himself the perfect Intercontinental Champion.
Don't they, Jim?
They sure do. I think Weasel's too good of a name for Bobby Heenan.
Perfect.
It's too nice.
The hot dog days of summer are here again. A certain British bulldog is now the number one contender for the Intercontinental title. And I'm sure that you've heard the old saying,
they better keep their eye on that baby boy Smith, I'm telling you, Monsoon.
Let me tell you something, Beefcake and everybody else. There's no doubt in my mind that the British Bulldog is the number one contender. He has the strength, he has the power, he has the wrestling knowledge, and I also know that he wants more than anything to bring the Intercontinental Championship belt back to England for the simple reason England has never had a winner in anything.
That's a lie.
Interesting to see. Welcome to Brutus's Barber Shop. You know, this week, I've got a man. He's the eighth wonder of the world.
Listen to the ovation for Andre. Boy, he's got a bad limp, and Kane, too. I guess he blew that knee right out, Anvil.
Yeah, when Earthquake, what does he weigh? 500 pounds and maybe more. But all that weight came down on Andre the Giant's knee. Gosh knows what the damage could have been done. The ligaments.
Boy, he's in bad shape.
Well, at least he can't kick.
No, Andre, it's surely a wonder to me that you're standing here right now.
Well, we all know that your knee is gonna require a lot of reconstructive surgery, that you're facing a lot of rehabilitation. And you know, I know all about what it takes to go through a lot of rehabilitation. But what all these people and what I wanna know is, what does the future hold for Andre the Giant?
Well, what it is, the doctor said he's supposed to put a new knee in there. But he said, I'm too young for it. And I really appreciate that. So now I asked him what he can do. And he told me, he said, only I can rebuild your knee and it'll be better than ever. I don't care about the Earthquake, I just care about my knee. And believe me, I'm going to get that doctor to rebuild that knee. And then, Earthquake, you start something I have to finish. That may be the last thing I have to do. We never know, but Earthquake, you start some trouble. It can be, in the end of that, your worst nightmare you ever had. I promise you that.
You know, Earthquake, you call yourself the natural disaster, but when you come face to face with an angry Andre the Giant, it can only spell disaster for you.
Disaster indeed. Andre the Giant says he'll be 100% again. I wouldn't want to be in Earthquake's shoes for anything.
And that includes you, Rowdy Roddy Piper. You and Beefcake are nothing but frauds. And I say you've been trimming on your taxes.
Well, it appears to me that the only thing that needs trimming around here, Mr. Shyster, is you.
a great barber, why can't you afford a whole outfit?
Tell him.
Give him a trim, Brutus. This Monday night on primetime, Brutus the Barber Beefcake's gonna be my guest. Wonder what he'll wear then.
Tremendous ovation here for Brutus in the barber shop.
Welcome to the barber shop. You know, my appointment's just about here. You know, these next two guys, they come from Bad Attitude Street in Chicago, man. And when these two dudes say something, hey, you better believe, man, they mean what they say and they get the job done. Yeah, that's right. I'm talking about the Legion of Doom.
Now you're going to see three guys with lousy haircuts.
I'm going to tell them, Weasel, that you said that personally.
I'm going to tell Hawk you made fun of his haircut.
I didn't mean Hawk.
You know, Hawk, I know you got a few things that you want to say about the Nasty Boys.
Barber, they say they're from the streets, too. They look like they're from the streets. They look like a couple of transits. You see, I know one thing. The streets of Chicago are a lot different than the streets you came from. That's like comparing the little yellow brick road to the highway to hell. Nasty Boys, sooner or later, you're gonna have to get in the ring with the Legion of Doom.
It's excitement, as always, here in Madison Square Garden. But, we've got Brutus music. Let's go to our ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the Barber Shop. And here is the proprietor, Brutus the Barber.
Listen to the ovation here for Brutus the Barber. In the world with you, man. Be quiet. Now, he needs it, Brutus. He needs a little bit.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce my guest tonight. He's a man he's had a long, illustrious history right here in Madison Square Garden. He's also a man that maybe a lot of you out here may not like. Maybe you do like him. But one thing's for sure, you do gotta respect this man. And I'm talking about the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Standing ovation here in Madison Square Garden.
You better respect
the Macho
him.
Man.
He's done it all here in the World Wrestling Federation. How can you not respect a man like this?
Tremendous respect being shown here for the Macho Man.
through my mind. So we're gonna kind of play like a little game tonight. I'm gonna be asking you some real simple questions. All you gotta do is answer yes or no. You get them all right, you win the grand prize.
I'll go for the grand prize, but I'll feel a lot better if you put those down, yeah.
Okay, Macho, we'll put these over here.
Don't you even think about it.
Well, you know, the first question that comes to mind when I'm thinking right now is, are you and Miss Elizabeth, could you say that you're an item?
I didn't know that you were going to get so personal.
Yes or no? Would you say it's safe to say that you and Miss Elizabeth have a relationship? Yes or no?
Yes, is the answer.
I'm 2 for 2, man. All right. Getting a little harder, though. Next question that comes to mind. Are you or are you not in love with Miss Elizabeth?
That's yes embarrassing, isn't it?
Let's just see how macho the Macho Man is.
I didn't hear the question.
A little evasive.
Are you in love with Miss Elizabeth or not? Yes or no? Yes.
Yes. Oh, yes.
He's in love.
A bit of an item. You have a relationship with Miss Elizabeth, and you have admitted in front of all these people that you are in love with Miss Elizabeth. Now, here's the big question, Macho Man. Are you going to ask Miss Elizabeth to marry you?
Good friendship.
Will you be quiet?
I'm glad you didn't bring me out here to put me on the spot or nothing.
Not me, brother. Yes or no?
I wouldn't answer him.
You're not up there.
I don't believe it. I just can't see him with flowers and candy proposing. There's something about it. I can't see it. What makes him think she'll say yes?
Will Brutus the Barber Beefcake have made a habit of asking for just a little bit more in my lifetime? Oh, yeah. So I do want something more. Now I'm going to ask you a question. Do you know where I want to marry Miss Elizabeth? If this Saturday I ask her to marry me and she says yes, do you know where I want to marry her?
No, I don't.
I want to marry her where? I've had a long and illustrious history. A place where I want to make history.
Wow! He wants to get married
At SummerSlam, did I get there right?
Oh, ladies and gentlemen.
A SummerSlam wedding is what he's got in mind.
And he can go over to Newark and get a divorce.
Sensational Sherry, shades of the fabulous Moolah.
Move that camera. Move it.
You are what? You're a lecherous sort, aren't you?
Well, thank you.
I never knew that.
Stick around.
So nice you could make it, Sherry. You know, I was just wondering, have you picked out your wedding gift for the Macho Man and Miss Elizabeth yet?
Yes, indeed, Beefcake. I picked out my gift for the Macho Man and the Miss Elizabeth. And I'd like to deliver it to them right now if they were right here. I'd like to deliver a slap to his face. And I'd like to puke all over her. The match made in heaven between the Macho King and Miss Elizabeth won't be so heavenly. It's not going to be the match made in heaven. It's going to be the match made in hell if I have anything to do with it.
Uh-oh. Oh, you know who's going to object.
Oh,
Sherry, by the way, I almost forgot. I've arranged your transportation to and from the wedding here.
Well, that's nice of him. Why would he want to do? Why would he want to be nice to
him? Here you go.
Serious.
Oh, like a cat scratching a kitty litter.
Brutus all decked out in white.
Who does his hair? The state?
I think he does his own.
He must.
Welcome to the barbershop, ladies and gentlemen. My appointment is on its way right now. Legion of Doom!
What an ovation for the WWF Tag Team Champion!
Intelligence come out of these two morons.
Well, just keep your ears open and your mouth shut, and you will.
Well, I've said it before, and I'll say it again. It's not the biggest, the strongest, and the baddest man who survives in this world, in this wrestling world, in this WWF. It's the one who's just a little bit sicker up here. And we fit that description to a T. And natural disasters, don't think I can't get you up on my shoulders. And Hawk comes out the top rope, gives you the doomsday device. And Hawk, what's it gonna be?
Boy, they certainly resemble that remark, Brain.
They're sick. She's got a belt tighter on her neck on the last notch.
Yo, this week, my guests are none other than The Undertaker and Paul Bearer.
Perhaps we're looking at the new World Wrestling Federation champion.
I got to hear what they're going to say. I got to hear this.
Keep quiet and listen. I learned something. A man of few words. Nice hairdo.
A Brutus? You're kidding.
Nice haircut if you're going to the chair. You're
supposed to tell us what's in the urn, too. You never did that.
Shut up. Big mouth.
You know, we all saw what you did to Hulk Hogan on the funeral parlor. We saw the despicable acts. We saw how you jumped somebody from behind, how you could take advantage and leave a man laying helpless. I think you're nothing but a bunch of grave robbing, backstabbing, slime of the earth, Mr. Paul Bearer and Mr. Undertaker. And I think that you made one critical error. You didn't get the job done. You didn't finish it when you had the chance.
Better shut up, Beefcake.
Just when Hulk Hogan thought he had all the answers, we changed the question. What a look! What a look on Hulk Hogan's face when my Undertaker appeared out of nowhere. What a look on his face when he was lying Survivor Series. My Undertaker will be the new WWF champion.
The will of Hulkamania has already been slain as Hulk Hogan fell on the floor of the funeral parlor, So did Hulkamania. This Wednesday night, after Hulk Hogan lays defeated, I'll reach into his chest and extract the soul of Hulkamania and plunge it into eternal darkness.
Now we're going to bring out a superstar who seems like whenever he is around, there's a hot situation, especially on the barber shop. Let's welcome Brutus, the barber beefcake. You look in tremendous condition, and I want to talk to you about some of the tight situations you've been involved in on the barbershop.
Well, you know, Sean, I love being here on primetime, and I've been having the best time at the barbershop. You know, we've
can I ask you one question? Since I'm a broadcast journalist, and I know what you've been through with your accident and the surgery you went through and how they rebuilt your face and everything, could you just turn to the camera there? And I mean, you have bolts, you have screws, you have metal plates, and you've probably got more bolts in your head and face than Ace Hardware. But I want to just check something out now. I want to make sure of something here and something here. Yes, those refrigerator magnets will stick.
Bobby Heenan, like, what he's been through.
Yeah, brilliant.
Just nothing to get upset about. Just an example and surgery.
You know something, Heenan? You shouldn't be so worried about my face. You should be worried about your own face.
You see what they did to my face?
You know, I did see what they did to you. But you know something? You are a lucky man because I just have something that's exactly the solution.
I don't want nothing from you, Beefcake.
Oh, wait a second now. This is a new formula, a special mask that even could take years off a mush like yours.
I don't care if it took...
Bobby, it doesn't look to me in very good shape.
Well, it does hurt, and it is a little hot, but you couldn't do nothing to me.
It's getting worse as the program goes on.
You're not going to cut my hair.
Oh, wait a minute. I didn't say I was going to do it. I'll bring my little assistant, Cookie, out here, and she will perform the whole... She will put the mask on.
I've seen some of them bow-wows you hang with. Those six-foot-tall bimbos look like olive oil. You're not suckering me into nothing, Beefcake.
It'll just take a few minutes, and I guarantee you, you will look 1,000 times better than you ever have.
I couldn't look any better.
That's some offer, Bobby.
Well, let me get her out here now. Cookie?
Cookie.
Come on out.
It's Cookie.
Hi, Mr. Heenan. I'm a big, big fan.
Oh. Come over here to cheer you, little Fig Newton. Come here.
I think he's going to take you up on your offer. What exactly are we going to do here, Brutus?
What you going to
do? I'm going to have Cookie apply this facial mask to Mr. Heenan's face, and this is made to get deep into the pores.
You're not going
to
touch me.
I won't touch you.
I'm going to be cookie eyes.
Deep clean and to take off all that ugly, scarred up, scummy looking skin all over your face and even make him look better.
No, they're like vitamins in here and emollients to help cleanse the skin.
Go. There you go.
Is this an autopsy?
Okay, well.
You are licensed, aren't you, Cookie?
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if you are or not.
I'm sure she can drive.
You give massages?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Just don't rub me the wrong... Oh, Cookie.
How's that feel, Bobby Heenan?
Oh.
It's very important
that
she covers the face in all the right spots and the cracks and the crevices. And rubs that in really
Cookie,
well.
Cookie, you got some dynamite paws on you. Oh, Cookie.
Yeah,
don't rub me the wrong way.
It looks like it's clearing
looks
up.
Like this may be the best thing that ever happened to you.
Cookie, I got some other parts that need a little massaging, too, you know, like my wrist. Like my wrist and stuff.
All right, a lot has taken place already here in primetime.
Nothing's taken place yet.
Watching Bobby Heenan getting a facial. Earlier, the Legion of Doom visited us here on primetime, and I'm sure you'd like to forget that experience, Bobby Heenan.
I don't know. It was kind of worth it, having cookie rubber or little cookie cutters on you.
Easy now. Mr. Perfect is somewhere in the building having a perfect suit made.
And he
certainly is. And how's it going here with Mr.
Heenan? It's looking real good there. It's looking real good. You know, it's going to take a little bit of time to set up now. We got to wait a little bit of time.
Will this get hard?
Oh, it gets, it hardens a little bit.
Looks like it's doing very well. Hey, Bobby Heenan, while you're waiting, maybe you want to play the 900 Hulk number.
Cookie, hit it.
Well, you folks at home certainly can do that right now. Pick up the telephone, call 1-900-454-HULK. And lose.
I want to call Cookie. What are you doing later?
So what is happening right now? Is it going to be like a cast?
Right now,
cast,
the catalyst, the special ingredients inside are doing their work. They're taking off that old, dead, slimy, scummy skin.
You believe Mr. Perfect said that was the greatest tailor in the world. Did you see the way he treated him?
It's like he treats everybody, man, like dirt.
Well, it looks as though he's in the process of finishing up his perfect suit.
How long do I have to keep this on, Cookie?
Oh, it's getting there.
It's looking real good there. It's
not asking you.
It's just about ready.
Cookie has it.
It's in Grumman's Chinese Theater.
Ready?
You think it's ready, Cookie?
Yeah,
has it set?
And what do you do? Peel it off or wash it off?
Well, we're ready for the solvent. Cookie, the solvent.
The solvent? Oh, you need a solvent to take this off?
Well, it was here somewhere.
Oh, don't start this now.
Well, there doesn't seem to be any solvent, Brutus. Is there another way to take it off?
Hey, you want to see the cookie crumble?
It's a special solution.
It won't come off with water?
Oh, absolutely not. No, it's a special solution.
We mean absolutely not!
Designed to take this off.
Well,
I guess we'll just have to go and find something. We can find something. Cookie and I, we'll go find something.
You mean go find something?
Bobby, just take it easy. They're going to be right back. They're going to try and find something to take it off. Right now, we'll take a look at this great matchup between Bret the Hitman Hart and Paul.
You got some of that last probably in front of him.
Well, now he's going to solve the problem.
I got it.
I told you he was coming back.
I got just what we need here. Dressing room here.
Brutus, that may have been a little bit extreme, huh? I don't know if that would do the job.
Plunger.
Okay.
There must be something else you can
I got
use
it. Here. I know I just what it'll take that off. I'll be right back. I got it.
Try a little scouring powder.
Well, he's still working on it.
He's really doing a heck of a job because I want a toilet plunger.
Who knows?
Is this cookie stuff going to sit on my face?
It may have. Who knows? It may have worked. Let's take any action involving the new.
Because out here with a toilet plunger with paper hanging from it, what's he going to do? Just jab me in the face and...
Well, who knows? It may have worked. We didn't even give it a shot. Here he comes. Now he's going to take care of it this time.
Okay, Weeze. Now, just take it easy. Just sit down. I'll have this right off you in a minute. But
promise me, please.
Just close your eyes, because I don't want to get any in your eyes. It's very important. keep your eyes closed.
I don't think that was going to work.
Okay,
there's got to be something else. No sign of the solvent.
Okay, wait, I got it. I'll be right back.
They don't have it!
When we return here
they
to prime
don't
time,
have clue. He said that. Oh, he's a guy you can listen
right
to.
Now of, getting something
to do you think he really cares about me?
You don't have to worry about it.
He don't care. I can get this off.
Out any minute, he has a there has got to be another way. Don't you think that was perhaps just a little bit extreme?
It would have worked.
Sure it would have worked, but
I got it.
Don't you think would have done better than work?
He's got it. Sure, that'll work. He had a toilet plunger, a big drill he uses on Andre. He had a on the sides and around the eyes, but it's tightening in the jaw. It's tightening in the mouth. I'm having trouble breathing. This stuff stinks.
I hope we get this off by next week.
Use the chainsaw. I don't care. Get it off
he
me.
He really wants this off.
Do whatever you want.
I can see
it. Get off me,
Bobby,
please.
Bobby, take it easy. Take it easy. I'm sure that he's got the answer.
I can see we need a little help. I think help is on the way. Come on in, guys.
And each of them doomed.
We're gonna take my hair off, right? You're gonna take that head off, right?
Here. What are you
going to
do?
I'm going to rip your face
from Legion of Doom.
Come here. Good news, huh?
We'll get it off for you.
Said use the
I don't know why you're so hesitant,
no,
Bob.
Wait a minute.
Come on, Bob. A
couple of nice guys like us won't hurt you.
Tell that.
Sit down, Bob.
On second thought, it's not that bad.
Don't worry
it's
about a thing.
Come on,
trust me.
Sit down, little man. Right here. Sit down, little man. I'll take
care
of
you. Come on, you guys hurt me already. I didn't mean to make a mistake.
Bobby, relax. Hawk's going to take it off for you.
Okay. Hawk, don't.
Come on, pull.
No!
Oh, God. Get it, Ann. Will you give it a shot?
It's really stuck
on slide
there.
Up, slide up, slide up. There you go.
Oh, boy, does that look painful?
No. Look at my ears. Look at my ears. Oh, God.
Hey, no, Ralph. Gary Stridham, where's he at?
We need Gary. Come on out, Gary. I got to get out
of here.
Stay right here.
We're trying to get this off him, Gary.
All right, guys, all three now.
Not all three of you. Ready?
One, two, three.
God, no!
Well, you look good, Bob.
You look good, Bobby. I like it.
You look real good.
You never looked better.
Oh, yeah.
How about that?
A marked improvement.
My face!
It'll go away in a few years.
You ruined my face!
You hear?
Years! I'll see you off.
And if you want to go on your own, then walk off and leave. If you want to stick together and make this thing work, when I turn around, we're going to shake hands and we're going to go on a rock and roll like the rockers can do.
They need each other. You know that.
Sounds fair to me.
He's not going to walk away.
They need each other.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Rockers!
Well, told you. I'm glad to see that.
Told you.
Tag team specialists.
See, one without the other isn't any good.
Oh, I knew he was going to do that. I just knew he was going to do that. He don't need Jannetty.
I told you that off and on.
Are you kidding? What a despicable act that was.
Jannetty tried to dive through the window to escape. Did you see that?
Are you blind?
What an act of cowardism.
Oh, he's hurt. A plate glass window.
Oh, look at that. He's busted wide open. We need a paramedic here.
Is there a problem?
I don't think so. Ladies and gentlemen,